an institution where there is systematic charity, should you not clap for that? Please remember, clap for it. Channelized charity, continuous charity, consistent charity. Man was made in the image of God. He alone can give. I hope you noticed that. Only man can give. Animals share sometimes by instinct. Only man can give, and that is where he comes closest to his maker. What happens when we do not give? The other side of the picture. We are possessed by our possessions. Sage Aurobindo said, let possessions not possess us. They do possess us. There was a time when Robin Hood robbed and gave. Today our politicians rob and save. That is why they are in prison. I hope you understand. What happens when you don't give? You are possessed by your possessions. And we are bogged down by these because the simple reason is we are obsessed by them. And we are worried about our successors. We cannot eat in joy nor sleep in peace. When we become aware of man and men and matters around us, that awareness is inspired by feeling, and feeling is the result of sensitivity. Everywhere there is suffering, everywhere there is poverty, everywhere there is ill health. Do not watch suffering like a tear-jerking, sensational, sentimental movie on the silver screen. Remember, we are part of humanity. Go back to that sagacious Albert Schweitzer who said, open your eyes and look for someone, man, some work for the sake of man, which needs a little time, a little friendship, a little sympathy, a little human toil. It is needed in every nook and corner. Therefore, search and see if there is not some place where you may invest your humanity. I like the phrase, people invest money only. Here is Schweitzer investing humanity. And he says, please look out for pockets of charity where you can invest your humanity. What a vibrant phrase. We begin to give and then life changes. You should give and experience this change. It is not something theoretical. It's something very practical. When you start giving, something happens. It disburdens you. Everywhere we see fitness centers, losing inches, losing pounds. What is charity, sir? Losing ego. That is what is charity. Giving means losing ego. The only way you can dispossess yourself and feel light. Go back to the Indian Railway, which says less luggage, more comfort. So much of luggage we have, unwanted luggage. Please travel light and see that other people are benefited by your charity. Only when we give, we are alive, in the true sense of the term. Looking back, which were the real moments we really lived? The moments when we came closest to our Maker? Destiny changes when we shift the emphasis from I to they. It's a shift of emphasis from myself to those people. Tensions are gone, stress gets relieved, and we are buoyant because we have someone disburdened of his problems. Even on the threshold of heaven, I give you an incident from the Mahabharata. It's a very, very significant incident. Yudhishthira, the hero, is ascending to heaven, and as he is going, a small little dog is following him. Sometimes a stray dog and you become friends. You look at the dog and the dog looks at you, and a strange rapport is established, a strange empathy and sympathy. When the time comes for Yudhishthira to get into the chariot of heaven, he refuses because the dog is not allowed. The charioteer says, dogs are not allowed. Yudhishthira says, I don't want a heaven where my little dog, which depended on me emotionally, is not allowed. Even on the threshold of heaven, here was a man who could practice charity. The dog jumps into the chariot and reveals himself as the god of death, telling Yudhishthira, we extol your love for humanity, your love for every creature in the world. According to the Gita, there are three commandments. यज्ञदान तपकर्म न त्याज्यम कार्यमेव हि तत्। दे आर नॉट हिंदू कमांडमेंट्स, दे आर यूनिवर्सल कमांडमेंट्स, दे कैन बी रोटरी कमांडमेंट्स। द फर्स्ट इज यज्ञ। यज्ञ इज थैंक्स गिविंग। 90% ऑफ अस गो टू द लॉर्ड एंड आस्क हिम फॉर समथिंग, बट व्हेन वी गेट व्हाट वी वांट, वी नेवर गो बैक टू थैंक। मैन इज द ओनली क्रीचर हु कंप्लेन्स अबाउट व्हाट ही डज नॉट हैव एंड कंप्लेन्स अबाउट व्हाट हिज नेबर हैज। That is the problem. Go back to thank the Lord. And thanking the Lord is gratitude. And I hope you know, the philosophers tell us gratitude is the greatest multiplier. Thousands of people in the world are there who make money and gather peacelessness for themselves. Thank the Lord that you joined the Rotary movement. Clap for yourself. Clap for yourself. Please remember that you joined this movement, you must be grateful to the Lord that you have like-minded people. There must be so many in the world who say, why don't you mind your own business, let the world go to the dogs. They must be saying, illi bandi yen madthirappa, yak barbeku rotary ge. This is how people would dissuade you from taking to Rotary. But be happy that you joined, be grateful that you joined a movement which is going to inspire you. The second commandment is dana. Dana is giving 1/10 of one's earning to someone who is not related to you. Are you noting my words? What you give your nephew and your niece is not dana. It's not charity. That is duty. Jaan se khalenge nahi to. You will have to suffer for it otherwise. But give someone who doesn't belong to you, someone far away, someone unconnected in the ordinary sense of the term, but super connected in the highest sense of the term. Because he is also a human being. Dana is charity, and that charity is a duty. People talk of CSR nowadays, corporate social responsibility. Have you gone a little deeper as I went into it? Corporate social responsibility has to be preceded by ISR, individual social responsibility. Unless you have individual social responsibility, you cannot have corporate social responsibility. Each one was born to give something to humanity, and we are incomplete if we do not offer this to humanity. Our wealth will remain stagnant. That is why we use the phrase stinking rich. Why do you use the word stinking rich when it is not given to humanity? Charity is a way of realizing the divine within us. And charity is inspired by feeling. Most of us feel only for ourselves. Swami Vivekananda said, feel. Feel until the head reels and the heart stops. How much can you feel for humanity? It is feeling and that concern which makes you give. What makes you give and how can you give? What are the ways of giving? Have you ever thought? It can be food, it can be clothing, it can be money, it can be home. The need is so great and the number is so large. When people say, I don't know where to give charity, I say, you're stupid. Open your eyes. Look, there are so many pockets of charity where you can invest your humanity. My dear listeners, my dear Rotarians, one day when I visited Los Angeles, a little child gets up and tells me, we in our school walked 5 miles to collect $1,000 for the poor children, slum children in your ashram. I was touched. I was touched when tiny tots walked 5 miles. 5 miles to collect $1,000. And the child says, ma'am, if every Indian child set aside $1 every month, there would be no hungry child in India. I said, I don't understand the arithmetic. But I see the logic of love behind it, my child. I said, I see the logic. Concern from that age. One can give time. Today in this mad world called life, there is no time. There's no time for anyone. Neither for one's husband, nor wife, nor children, nor parents, nor brothers, nor sisters, nor friends. Certainly not for society. That is why we are tense. We can give love. When you spare time and give love to your parents. Matridevo bhava, pitridevo bhava. today we have no time for our parents. What is the use of building schools and colleges in their names after they have departed from their world? They don't want your check. They want your love. One little tear, one pranam, asking for their blessings, and you'll go a long way. Please remember that we don't have time for anyone. We don't have time to love anyone. Give intellectually. The best dana that you can give is Vidya Dana. And I'm sure Rotary has been doing so much in this field also. Please give them a big hand. In the field of medicine, field of health, in the field of education, so much, so many scholarships are given. That is how you can help humanity. Education is the best gift you can give children, along with your children's school fee, which is exorbitant nowadays. Please pay for the fees of a poor child and see how your child becomes brilliant. This is what is called the balance of nature. It's called the balance of nature. Your child will do well when you pay for another poor child's fee. What should the attitude of the giver be? Very sensitive area that I'm coming to. Swami Vivekananda said, when man gives something to someone, his ego meter reading is at its highest. I am giving and he is receiving. Charity cannot work under compulsion, or else like a blocked pipe, it'll give way after a while. Charity should be spontaneous. Giving should not be for publicity, excuse me. While handing over a gift or a check to a poor child, do not face the TV camera. It's not for publicity. Giving should not be viewed as a rivalry, and Rotarians know that. May I tell the district governor that in business you have competitors, in charity you have compliments. You hear me? In business